Yeah, good afternoon to all students. Can you hear
good
me?
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah.
Good afternoon.
May I audible to all?
Yes, sir.
I'm just greeting to all. You can, if you have any query, you can write in chat box. Okay, so in the last class we have seen that very important concepts. So I'll just take a recap. I think we have started with the basic conceptual thing like what is simple random sampling, then some notations, then some terminology which is terms like sample, population, then their relationship between population variance and population mean square. Then we have seen very important part, the distribution of selecting any random sample, then what could be their probability. Then we have found and we have shown that in both the case, whether it is SRS-WR or whether it is SRS-WR, we are getting probability same, right? This was the probability we found in both the cases. Then we have shown that expected value of yi is equivalent to your y bar, and we found the variance of yi is nothing but sigma square, and we have calculated the covariances also in the both the cases, right? And I think we have stopped there, and now today we will going to see estimation of population mean. Okay, before I start estimation of population mean, I just wanted to know, there are 27 students only joined so far. Where are others? Can you start? All of you, can you start your video? Can you start your video? Please start your video. I just want to see, where are others? I just want to see the faces of all the students, because just knowing the name, I cannot recognize. So, just wanted to see who are the students who has joined. Okay. Oh, 30 students joined so far. Okay. Fine. You can turn off your video. I hope you are all working on GC and you are performing. Like you are conducting the assignments and quiz. So hopefully the next week I will update about that. So let us begin the first estimation of population mean. So we have seen last class expected value of yi, which we found at y bar. So we are going to use again those concepts. And variance of yi is nothing but sigma square. Okay, so those concepts we are going to use again here. So I just want to show you, start with this. So if you see these concepts, here you have population mean, which is mu, okay, which is called as parameter, which is basically a parameter, and t is statistics, and you know what is the population mean and what is the statistics. And there's one terminology which we are using, which is called, this statistics T is called as unbiased estimate, is called as unbiased estimator if and only condition is given here. What is the condition? The condition is expected value of t is equal to mu. So whenever expected value of t is equal to mu, that means expected value of any statistics is equivalent to your parameter, we always conclude that that estimator become a unbiased estimator. Okay, so to understand that unbiased estimator, let's take one example. So let us consider, let's say y bar. Okay, so you know what is y bar. Y bar is your population mean. So if we have this y bar, which is generally notation, we have already seen 1 upon n summation yi as an estimator of population mean. Now the estimator of population mean, so I'm just defining this is mu. Okay, this is the mu. So mu is your population mean. I wanted to show whether this equivalent to y bar. Y bar, you know y bar is what? Y bar is a population mean which we replaced. Okay, so this is also, see, this is I'm talking about the population. Okay, but if you think of sample which you have calculated, then you call this is the y bar, capital y bar. Okay, always remember. So you want to show this expected value of small y bar is equal to capital y bar. So consider small y bar. So we know that this is our sample mean. Now taking expectation on both the sides, if the expectation here and expectation here, then 1 upon n summation, because you can pull out 1 upon n out because it is constant. Therefore, expected value of summation of yi will in bracket. You can take expectation inside. It's very simple result. We already know these results. But what you are knowing about this expected value of yi? This is equal to what? This is equal to y bar, because we are already knowing this is equal to y bar. Now here I am repeating this condition, means I is running from 1 to n y bar. Now since this summation, inside the summation, it is the constant value. Okay, and I is running from 1 to n. I is running from 1 to n, and we know if there is a constant value inside and summation is anything, we always multiply with that value will be n. So it is n y bar. So this n n will get cancelled, which turns out to be capital y bar. So this is the result we have found. Okay, generally we use these results, so just always know these results is quite useful. So this is equal to so we have proved that, what we have proved, that expected value of y bar is equal to small y bar is equal to capital y bar. Hence what you can conclude here, sample mean, which is y bar, small y bar, is an unbiased estimator of population mean, which is capital y bar. Okay, so this is sometime result they ask, show that sample mean is unbiased estimator of population mean. So you have to start from here. We know that this, then you perform this basic calculations and it turns out to be the result. Then we are interested to obtain variance of y bar. Okay, we are interested to obtain variance of y bar. So how to obtain this variance of y bar? We know that again y bar, small y bar is this. Now before calculating the small y bar, variance of y bar, you must know this result. What is this result? 1 upon whenever if I'm taking variance of, if I'm saying variance of ay, okay, and we know what a is constant. So whenever a is constant and when you pull out a out, it's become a square. This results we are knowing very well. It's very famous results. Okay, it's very famous result. I think this results were taken by the Jay sir. Hope you are all you can recall this results. So go to back in FIBSC. If you have any query, you can take down that notes. And even if you refer any book related to expected value, you can get this results. Very easy results. Okay. So when I take the variance of this part, variance of this quantity, okay, when it's of this quantity, 1 upon n is constant, you can pull out. So whenever you take pull out, it's become an n square. And variance of summation of y, variance of summation of y, okay. So what happened here actually? Oh, just a minute. So here there is one result in case of variance. So whenever we are interested to obtain the variance of summation of yi, now summation is inside, okay, summation is inside, it is not outside. If it is outside, then problem has been solved because the variance of yi we are already knowing. But now inside the variance we have the summation, okay. So there is one in there is one conceptual in the case of variance. Whenever the we are obtaining the variance and whenever summation is inside, what we have to do and how we have to do, okay. So always remember, there is one result. Whenever variance of summation of some variable you are obtaining, so how we can get this? This is equal to first term summation I takes value 1 to n, take this variance inside, okay. If you take variance inside, it's become variance of yi plus, okay, plus double summation I and j over the range of I and j, but I is not equal to j, okay. This condition have to always put into covariance between yi and yj. So whenever you are obtaining the variance of any summation, you have to always go for these results, okay. So just understand this result, how you can obtain this, okay. And based on this, so using some inequality, we have derived this result, okay. So there will be no derivation of this. There will be no derivation. You can just note down these results in your examination. Just write it down here, okay. Using this, one can get this directly. Now till here, I hope there will be no difficulty. Now let's check under SRS WR, okay. WR, okay, it is with replacement. So we have found that with replacement, the covariance is, we know that with replacement, variance of yi is sigma square and covariance is zero. If you know this, if you see the last lecture properly, you have gone through the notes, we have found that under SRS WR, the covariance is zero. If the covariance is zero, then it turns out to be 1 upon n square. This is 1 upon n square summation variance of yi, because this is 0. This is 0, that means whole thing will be 0. The summation of sigma square. Okay. So again, summation inside constant, it will be n times sigma square into n square. So we found that it is sigma square by n. So this is the results under WR. Now this sigma square, we have seen the relationship between population mean square and variance, population variance. So using that results, one can directly write this also, because we know that what sigma square is equal to, what is sigma square? That sigma square is equal to, I hope you are knowing this, it is n minus 1 upon n into capital S square. Don't forget, huh? In exam, I think 20% students write small or capital. I'm itself get confused. Okay, so whenever you're writing capital, use capital, don't use small. Okay. Similarly, in the case of WOR, we get the same variance. Under SRS WR, we'll get the same variance, because the probability will be the same. Okay. And the covariance we have found that minus sigma square by n. I hope you remember the covariance. I think in the last class we have obtained the covariance. It is here. Okay. So this is, we have already seen sigma square by n. So you can just substitute here. Okay. You can just substitute here. And if you just substitute, this quantity will be here. You can just see this sigma square. You can just substitute sigma square here, and we have minus sigma square divided by n minus 1. So here sigma square is common in the both the cases. You can pull out, and summation is running with the constant 1, so it is n time. This minus you can pull out. Now There is one concept here. I is running from one to small n. J is running from one to small n. Correct? But I is not equal to J. I is this results. This condition we are already knowing. Okay? I is not equal to J. Okay. So if I take value 1 to j, I take value 1 to j, 1 to n, so it will be n. Okay. But j cannot take up to n because I is already taken, so it will be 1 minus. That means whatever number of observations we have, take 1 minus because I can't be equal to j. Okay. That's why it is n minus 1. And capital N minus 1 is already there, no problem. So if you just get simplify this, even you can pull out n out. If I pull out n out here, one n will get cancelled with this n. Correct? So we are remaining with n here. Okay? So 1 minus remaining quantity is it. Get simplify this, just do the cross multiplication. If you simplify, your turns out to be n minus small n divided by capital N divided by capital N into sigma square by N. So this is the very important result. Okay. So under WR we have sigma square by N. Okay. Under WR we get this only this quantity. Correct. But under WOR we are just multiplying this much extra quality, this much extra constant. Okay, so that we can understand the difference between these quantities. Now, we can do a little bit approximation. Now, if you convert in terms of sigma square, means S square, so what will be the result? So, if you just, we know, because since we are already knowing this result, and sigma square is equal to N minus 1 S square, so sigma square becomes this one. So, just replace this sigma square by S square. If you just replace this sigma square by S square, what could be the result? N minus 1, N minus get cancelled. Remaining is here n minus n capital N into small into S square. So this is sometime this is the sometime we are going to use this result also. Okay. So this result is also helpful. This result is sometime also helpful. So you can always go with this result also. Okay. This result. This one, and sometimes we use this one also. Okay, sometimes we use this one also. So, based on the you can say which result we want, based on that we are finding WR. And here you can see, if I replace this small n by capital N, this quantity is called as sampling fraction. So you will know what is sampling fraction maybe in the coming session. So whenever we have a ratio of sample with the population, and that is called as a sampling fraction. Then we have a efficiency between WR, WOR and WR. Means which one is better? I want to check with the efficiency between WR and WOR. Okay. So what will be efficiency? So let me stop first here and let me ask you if you have any doubt. Okay. So you can chat box is open for you. You can ask if you have any queries there. Let me see the chat box. I hope you are clear with the expected value of y bar. Any difficult expected value of y bar here? Any query? Okay. Sir, please repeat once again. What do you want to repeat? Class. Which one you want to repeat me? I think this is
sir, after y bar.
Huh? Sorry?
After y bar, expectation of small y bar equals to Sir, expectation of small y bar equals to capital.
Okay. Then variance of y bar, right? Okay. So variance of y bar ke liye, just remember the this is the result which basically use it, right? Your voice is not coming. You can put on the chat box, na?
मैं सिखाऊंगा देखो तू बताना मेरे को
आई कांट हियर यू यू कैन पुट ऑन
लिखने बोला चैट बॉक्स
कैन पुट ऑन चैट बॉक्स
इधर चैट बॉक्स
सो दिस रिजल्ट
क्या है सर इधर अजीन सर का ये नहीं खाने का
नॉर्मल अजीन सर
या
कैसे पीछे जा रहा
है यस बोलो
चैट बॉक्स
क्या है चैट बॉक्स चालू जो देखता पब्लिक लिख रही ना वही से मैं भी लिख रही हूं
Please unmute yourself if you don't have any doubt. I hope you can understand.
मतलब मेरे दोस्त लोग बोलेंगे तू मुझे साथ दे मेरे दोस्त लोग बोलेंगे
Okay, so if you have any query, you can put on chat box. Okay. So till here there is no problem. I'm assuming that. And if it is here, then we know that variance of WOR means under WOR, we know this result. Just substitute, you can get this. There is no difficulty, I think, because here till here we are just substituting the previous result only. Till here we are just substituting the previous result only. Okay, last part. Then WOR. Don't say last part. You just specify the name. You have to specify whether it is SRS WOR or SRS WOR. How I should the last part? Last part means where? Okay, you can just specify the name. Variance of y bar. Because here I think that there could not be any difficulty because it is just using the previous results. Okay, and here also we are using the previous results only. Variance of y is equal to sigma square, which is given to you. And covariance we have already found there, and we have just substituted here. I don't know where you're getting difficulty. Just substitute here, get sigma square out. Once sigma square out, get simplify karenge to result mil jayega. And once you have the result in terms of sigma square, you change with the s square. I wanted to change with the capital S square. So you have this, you have relation between these two. Use it and get simplify. You'll get this one. You have to write it and practice, huh? Because this is derivations. Once you write it down, then only you can able to understand. Just since we are using the all previous results, there will be just simple substituting calculation, nothing else. Okay. So now we want to see the efficiency of y bar. Efficiency of y bar under SRS WR and SRS WOR means which one is better. Which one is better? Whether the variance of y bar under WR is better or variance of WOR better? So we are knowing these two results, which is n minus n s square, n minus n small s square, and these results again we have just now found. Here, if you see this variance of y bar. Under WOR, we have found this, correct? Just now seeing this result, this one, okay? This result we have written here again. And WR, what is WR? It is this one, n minus 1 divided by capital N minus small n into S square, capital S square. So I have written this quantity will be here. Now if you see here, what I did here, this quantity I have adjusted. If you just subtract here n and add n, okay, so if you just write this n minus 1, so n minus 1 can be written as what? N capital N minus small n plus small n minus 1, right? Small n minus 1. So this much we have done here adjustment. Otherwise, You can see here, this is the same, this is the same. Just make adjustment this quantity and get simplified. Now what about this quantity first? What about this quantity? This quantity we know very well. This quantity is nothing but your variance of y bar under WOR. Plus this is positive quantity. Plus this is positive quantity. So what you can think here, what you can assume here, what you can understand using these results, your variance of y bar under WR is equal to variance of y bar under WR plus some quantity, plus some quantity. Okay, that means this quantity will be greater. Why it is greater? If I say phi, this, let's say this is phi. Okay, so phi is equal to, let's say 2 plus 3. Okay, 2 plus 3. Okay, so what you can think here, this is some positive quantity. Okay, if I omit this, this will be the, this quantity will be greater. Okay, so this is, that means if this quantity is equivalent to this plus this, that means your left hand side will be always greater than right hand side. Hence, which efficiency is less, means which variance or which y bar having less variance. So I think if I write in reverse way, variance of y WOR means WOR will be lesser than WR. Okay, WOR is lesser than WR. That means that variance of y bar is more efficient than WR. Are you getting why I'm saying more efficient? And what, it is WOR, not WR. So whoever the variance is having less variance, okay, whichever is less, that is more efficient than other one. Are you getting my point? So this variance or this y bar is having less variance as compared to WR. Therefore I can say that WOR is a more efficient than WR. So is anyone having any difficulty here? Please go to chat box and write it down. Kishan Jaiswal is there? Kishan Jaiswal is there?
Hari, kya ho gayi? Yes, sir.
Beta, you unmute yourself. If you have any question, then only can then only can unmute. Okay? Please. If you have any questions, then only you unmute yourself and ask and unmute yourself. Yes. Any question is there so far? Efficiency means which variable having more power? Which estimator is good? So if you have a more than two estimator, I wanted to know which one is better. Okay, which one is more efficient? Which one is more powerful? Okay, so whenever the variance, whichever the estimator having the less variance, then we can call that estimator is a more efficient. Okay. Any other question is there? Yes, Roshni Boliye. Roshni is there? Okay, no question. Great. Okay, let me proceed. Now, once this is done, means we have found that WOR is more efficient than WR. Matlab, variance of Y bar under without replacement is more efficient than under with replacement, right? Okay. means if I say in terms of other sense, the variability, you know what is variability? Variance. Variability means variance. Variance under WOR is less. WOR, remember, without replacement, is less as compared to with replacement. Why it happens? Can you tell me why it happens? Why WOR having less variance as compared to WR? Anyone? Anyone? Write it down chat box. Write it down chat box. Why WOR is having less variance as compared to WR? So far there is no answer. Yeah, I am okay. WOR number is not repeat. Okay, correct. Correct. Because in WOR we are getting the less number as compared to WR. Okay, in WR the number can be repeat. Number can be repeat. So here number can be repeat. That means there could be the chance that the variability will be more as compared to WR. Okay. Let us proceed. Now we need to obtain the variance, estimation of variance from sample. Here we are talking about population. So if you see this, we have seen here, and we are trying to use even if it is a population. Here we have a population. We don't have any samples here. Even if you want to calculate this value, we need population variance, okay? But actually we don't have population. We have to work on sample. So how to obtain, means how to, from where we can estimate this variance of y bar, how we can do it, okay? So for that purpose, we have here estimation of variance of y bar from sample, okay? From sample. So here we are using actually sample value, correct? So this expression, we know that the variance of sample means involve S square. S square, you know what is capital S square, population mean square, which is based on the population value, which is based on the population value. Therefore, we cannot calculate it. In real life, it is difficult. So we have to estimate the population of y bar. Estimate means we have to do the estimation part. Okay. Now, what is the estimation part that we will see? On the basis of small y bar, on the basis of samples, okay. And now I'm going to use samples. Therefore, we are already knowing an estimated S square, which is capital S square, which is equivalent to sigma square, is needed. That means actually we are interested on small S square, okay, because we are calculating based on sample. Consider capital S square. Now we are using capital, we are considering the capital S square. Is an estimator of small s square. Means actually, what I'm trying to say here, the capital expected value of s square, capital s square, is an estimator of small s square. Means whether this quantity will be true or not. Okay, this is equal to. Okay. It's not starting. Okay. Anyways, it's not starting. That's okay. So we are interested here. Expected value of S square is equal to small S square. Expected value of S square is equal to small S square. Okay. Just give me time. It's and actually. I'm just sharing once again the screen. Just give me a minute. It's opening. So here, what I'm trying to say, expected value of S square is equal to, expected value of S square is equal to capital S square is equal to small s square. Okay. Is equal to small s square. Now, small s square, that means that, see, whenever I say small s square, it will be always cut. Okay. This is you're called population variance, where denominator is n. This is denominator is n minus 1. So this capital S square is equivalent to your population sample variance. Sample mean square. Okay, sample mean square, that means denominator is n minus 1. So is this equal or not? Okay, so I have to just check this. If this is equal, then I can replace this quantity by this quantity. That is basically called as estimation of variance from sample. Okay. So let's proceed. So here, if I just define population mean square, we know the formula for population mean square, right? Can I write this quantity become this quantity? I hope you are very simple to write this is become this. I have already given the explanation for this, and we are using the same formula for that. So you can go to the formula list and you can check. Now here you take expectation both the sides. So if you take expectation both the sides, what you can find here? You can pull out n minus 1 out and expected value of yi minus n minus y bar as it is. Take expectation inside. It's very simple steps, I think. And what we are knowing about this quantity? I know there is one result. Variance of y bar is equal to variance of y is equal to expected value of yi square minus expected value of yi ka whole square. Okay. So if you just calculate that term, you can get simplify and get this term. Similarly, here also expected value of y bar square, which is equivalent to variance of y bar plus expected value of y bar ka whole square. Okay. It's very simple steps, just a matter of calculation. So if you have any query, you can use this result. Variance of y by I is equal to expected value of y bar, or you can say y square minus expected value of y whole square, right? This is the whole square. Okay. So using this results, I have completed this one. And once we have this already we are knowing is equal to sigma square, and we have used expected value of y is equal to capital Y bar. The result we have already proved, right? Variance of y bar keep as it is, and again this is equal to y bar square. If you see this calculation, what you can find this calculation? N into y bar square with plus sign, n into y bar with minus sign will get cancelled. Remaining is n sigma square minus n time variance of y bar. So this is the results we have found. Again, I'm going to use two cases. WR, I know this result. Substitute here, will be turns out to be, we have proved that expected value of small s square is equal to capital sigma square. So this means sigma hat square is equivalent to small s square. This very important result is here. Okay. So this is equivalent to this. I hope you are getting what I did. I am using this expression, and WR I am already knowing this result. Just not derived. Substitute there, and we get simplified, and we'll get this expression. Similarly, if you do it for WOR also. So WOR I have this expression. You have just not derived. Okay, and what I did here, again I am using this result, and I'm substituting variance of y bar will be here. So if you see variance of y bar, I have substituted here. This will be same. Now here the variance of y bar we have in terms of s square. Okay, so this is also converted in terms of s square. So s square, I'm already knowing how to convert in s square. Okay, so this is get cancelled. Remaining is 1 minus f s square. Here we are not getting any cancel. बट आई नो एफ इज स्मॉल एन अपॉन कैपिटल एन. एफ इज स्मॉल एन अपॉन कैपिटल एन. इफ आई गेट मल्टीप्लाई विल गेट दिस रिजल्ट. योर डिनोमिनेटर इज सेम, यू कैन पुल आउट एंड यू कैन जस्ट मेक लिटिल बिट कैलकुलेशन एंड गेट सिंप्लीफाई, गेट टर्न्स आउट टू दिस. दिस इज द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. So with this, I think you can understand the results. This is the very important results, basically, which we are going to use it. So I'll unmute to all. If you have any questions, who is Ilyas Warrior? Iliad Warrior is there? If you have no cue, you can mute yourself. What is wrong with that guy? Okay, so if you have any query, you can ask. This is the problem. Now we have left with only 7 minutes, so I'm just sending the feedback form. If you have any questions, you can ask at any stage or any step which you not understood or you wanted to repeat me. I hope you are all writing these notes on your notebook. Please write it down, these notes on your notebook, so that you can understand each and every steps, each and every steps, and if you have any query related to that, you can ask even this time or next time. So I have just shared the feedback form. You fill it. And if you have any questions, you can discuss. I hope everybody is working on JC. So hopefully next week I will update, maybe assign the marks and everything. Any question is there? Any questions? I hope the feedback form is opening. Right? Feedback form is opening, right? So no query is there? Write today's topic, what you understood by today's topic, estimation or what else. Just write estimation, because major part we did in estimation, right? So please write down these topics, these notes till where we have done it, and hopefully I will update your GC adding with new quiz based on these topics very soon, maybe the till next week up, and continue with your quiz. That's okay. You can write. That's okay. You can write the topic. There is no problem. So there's no doubt. Okay. So if you have no doubt, then we can stop. There is no problem. But you go through the. Yeah, Pankaj Sindhe, you have raised your hand. Any difficulties there? You can unmute yourself and you can talk. Because in next part, which is totally based on the previous part, okay? So I hope the next lecture I will finish this topic because I have two lectures. And it's totally based on your previous lectures. Okay, so if you not go through the previous lectures properly, you will not understand. Okay, you will not understand the coming topics. So please go through, write it down each and every steps, step by steps. And if you have any query, then definitely we will discuss next class. Okay, so see you on Saturday. Have a good day.